is a beautiful early Saturday evening in the heart of Silicon Valley, San Jose, California, where for the second time ever, these fans welcome the NHL's best players. The biggest names in the game, like Edmonton's 22-year-old superstar Connor McDavid, share the stage with Stanley Cup champions, including the Penguins' Sidney Crosby, on hockey's star-studded night. We welcome you to the 64th NHL All-Star Game and the Honda Sports Desk here at the SAP Center in downtown San Jose. Good evening, everyone. I'm Mike Tirico. What a great time it is for the National Hockey League. Young, talented stars, their skill and speed on display almost every night, and we'll see it in spades on this ice tonight. For the fourth consecutive season, the NHL All-Star Game takes the regular season overtime format. So it's three skaters apiece on ice throughout. It means a ton of great scoring opportunities. We're out west, so the three 20-minute games will start with a first game between the Central and the Pacific Division stars. The second game will be the stars of the Atlantic against the stars of the Metropolitan Division. And the two winners will meet in a 20-minute game, winner take all, $1 million on the line to be split amongst the 11 All-Stars. When you watch hockey on a regular basis, you get to overtime. It is some of the best hockey you see all year. And you get to see it all night here in San Jose. The fans are primed, and from just up the road in Palo Alto, the Stanford Band is not on the field, but on the ice to get festivities going.
Number 35, Pekka Rinne. From the Nashville Predators, number 59, Roman Josi. From the St. Louis Blues, number 90, Ryan O'Reilly. From the Winnipeg Jets, number 26, Blake Wheeler. From the Winnipeg Jets, number 55, Mark Scheifele. And the captain of the Central Division, from the Colorado Avalanche, number 29, Nathan MacKinnon. Now, it's your 2019 Pacific Division NHL All-Stars. The captain of the Pacific Division from the Edmonton Oilers, number 97, Connor McDavid. From the Anaheim Ducks, number 36, John Gibson. From the Arizona Coyotes, number 9, Clayton Keller. From the Calgary Flames, number 13, Johnny Gaudreau. From the Edmonton Oilers, number 29, Leon Draisaitl. From the Los Angeles Kings, number 8, Drew Doughty. From the Vancouver Canucks, number 40, Elias Pettersson. From the Vegas Golden Knights, number 29, Marc-Andre Fleury. Now, from your San Jose Sharks, number 8, Joe Pavelski. From your San Jose Sharks, number 65, Erik Karlsson. And from your San Jose Sharks, number 88, Brent Burns. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remove your caps. Here with the presentation of today's colors, welcome the soldiers and airmen of the California Army and Air National Guard. Singing the Canadian National Anthem, please welcome Canadian country music star, CCMA award winner, and former Vancouver Canucks draft pick, Chad Brownlee.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh Canada, stand on guard for thee.
And now, singing the United States National Anthem, please welcome award-winning singer, Columbia recording artist and songwriter, Lauren Hurecki.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and streaming, and the rockets regular
The best in the world ready to hit the ice. 64th NHL All-Star Game. The best in the biz, Mike Emmerich and Eddie Olczyk, up next.
San Jose, SAP Center, 64th NHL All-Star Game, the fourth three-on-three All-Star Tournament. The first 20-minute game features the All-Stars from the Central and Pacific Divisions. And the Honda starting goaltenders. Pekka Rinne of Nashville, reigning goalie MVP from last year, according to his GM David Poile, the most impactful player in Nashville team history. John Gibson of the Anaheim Ducks, native of Pittsburgh, part of a rare shutout with Jonathan Quick in the Pacific $1 million 1-0 win in Nashville 3 years ago. All Sharks are starting. They are the three, Pavelski and Burns and Carlson, against two Jets, Scheifele and Wheeler with Patrick Kane. The first back check belongs to Scheifele, but Pavelski across and unable to pull the trigger on the shot is Burns. Joe Pavelski around behind, got it in front for Carlson. The rising backhander got the glass. Reaching out with Scheifele, puck taken by Burns. The bearded one plays to Pavelski, then to Burns, and across to Carlson for a shot deflected into the mask of Rinne, and then he's able to paddle it aside, and Scheifele shakes it along, and Wheeler takes over. Headman pass to Scheifele, moving up with Patrick Kane. Crisscrosses and drops it to Kane in his eighth All-Star game, the most of anyone here. Kane drops it back off, and it's taken again by Scheifele, and now the first shift change of the game going on the part of the Central. Ryan O'Reilly fought it free out in front, score! That goal collected by Nico Rantanen, the second leading scorer in the entire league, and it's 1-0.
Member of the Colorado Avalanche, and Ryan O'Reilly of the St. Louis Blues actually loses control of that puck. I don't know if Connor McDavid's the one that chips it out in front. No, it's O'Reilly, and then a little backhand forehand off the post in behind John Gibson.
And he does that with regularity, whether it's 5-on-5, 5-on-4, or 3-on-3, Mikko Rantanen. Probably the quietest 84 points anybody had in an NHL season last year.
Member of the Colorado Avalanche. A dynamic line, but the third member of that line is not able to play today, Nathan MacKinnon. So he has been given another job. He is there next to Paul Maurice, and he's coaching the Central today. He's in charge of the bench. Here's a feed in front, and trying to finesse it free was O'Reilly right out in front. Score! That goal from Gabriel Landeskog, the other member of the Avalanche, out on this unit. Two goals in 30 seconds.
Both by the Avalanche representatives, and their line mate, as you mentioned, Doc, standing on the bench, giving high fives all around. Nathan MacKinnon, and there you see Landeskog put it into the empty net, and a couple of apples, couple of assists for Ryan O'Reilly here. What a great first shift in the All-Star game for Ryan O'Reilly,
who used to be part of the Colorado Avalanche.
Haskinen brought it in, dropped it back. Now it is Wheeler with it. Because of the shortage of players, normally they're enough for three lines in a three-on-three, but with the absence of MacKinnon due to injury, they have to move up in sort of odd pairs whenever there's a shift change. Here is Burns shaking it off the boards, taken there and held around behind by Johnny Gaudreau, whose father is helping out at the Pacific bench today. His father, Guy, lending a hand to Bill Peters. This is brought back in by Roman Josi and fed across, and that away from Wheeler. Chipped along now, nicely ranked through traffic until it was lost by Josi, and Burns ahead. That went off Gaudreau, finesse free by Haskinen from the Dallas Stars and put on the stick of Roman Josi. A rare time when there are two defensemen out there, and it winds up becoming and offside.
Well, Doc, you made mention of Nathan MacKinnon. There he is, standing on the bench, and got to be pretty proud of his line mates. Off to a heck of a start.
Those line mates have gotten 79 goals and 199 points this year in just 50 games for the Avalanche. Magnificent. Thrown by O'Reilly in front, held there by Kane, and then popped on along. Kane able to take it further. Kane is forced back out to center. Very persistent checking that time by Drew Doughty. Doughty of the Kings turned away from Kane. Had to drop back defensively as Kane swung that one back down. An onside play as Ryan O'Reilly is around behind. O'Reilly tried to shake it in front. There normally aren't many faceoffs, but if there were some, and I was Coach O'Reilly, take them all. He tends to take them all in games anyway. As Kane tried to work his way through, but Elias Pettersson of the Vancouver Canucks takes over and connects with Clayton Keller from the Arizona Coyotes. Keller laid it on back, and it's slung to the front, taken by Pettersson, dropped for Keller, but instead peeled off by Mark Scheifele of the Winnipeg Jets, and played ahead, and here comes Kane. Save made by Gibson. Long toss ahead. Carried back on by Dreisaitl across to McDavid, trying to get it through to Dreisaitl. Oh, and it's followed by Rene, and off the pipe. Laid back across, it's McDavid bringing it on. He's got Dreisaitl, but can't get it through. Landeskog brings it on, has Haskinen nearby. Landeskog peeling and holding. Haskinen played it off, and it'll be regathered eventually by Rantanen and will play in the safety of center. Nearly halfway through the first 10 minutes. Normally, goaltenders are changed at the horn at the 10-minute mark. This one is sent ahead and cannot be chased down by Carlson. And a big awe goes up from the San Jose faithful here. Chased on now and can be taken by Rantanen and sent across the net mouth wide. Bouncer right around and a nice poke check there by John Gibson on Rantanen. And steaming on ahead. Score!
Humans here in San Jose, but John Gibson should get an assist on this play. The goaltender chips it up to Carlson. And the Pacific gets on the board. Hometown hero, Erik Karlsson.
The thrill of seeing the best guys out there all in one place. The Honda NHL All-Star Game, and already three goals have been scored with Eddie Olczyk. Mike Emmerich, what do you think?
Well, I don't think the goaltenders are probably too thrilled, Doc, but you know what? We like to see offense, and I think when you get into three-on-three format, what we've learned, and I think it's been a great job by the National Hockey League to go to three-on-three in the All-Star Game, there's nowhere to hide out there. And as the games go on, the heart rates will certainly go up with that $1 million on the line for the winning team. So a good start here, and some beautiful goals and a couple of big-time saves as well.
Patrick Kane across, and it is buried into the net. A great goal scored there by Roman Josi, and it is 3-1.
Well, the pace of the game is picking up after that TV timeout. Patrick Kane going to work, driving wide, and what a pass through Brent Burns onto the stick of Roman Josi, and he just finishes that like he's a 50-goal scorer. One of the most underrated defensemen in the National Hockey League, Roman Josi of the Nashville Predators, makes it 3-1 Central.
Oh, a heck of a pass there from Patrick Kane right between the legs of Brent Burns, and all Josi has to do is shovel that puck towards the empty net.
There are some interesting stories on how all of the line combinations and teams get assembled here. Once they arrive, of course, they talk a lot about the skills until that's over. Here's Kane with a short side shot. He scores! Patrick Kane makes it 4-1.
Roman Josi, a little payback there, Eddie. He'll get the assist to Kane on the stretch pass.
The release of Kane here is what does it. Not much there, quick little stick handle, and then finds that small little opening in between the legs of John Gibson.
takes you back to 2010. Patrick Kane, game six in Philadelphia, to the back of the net and winning the first cup for Chicago since 1961.
Pierre, there was one distinct difference.
We saw it go in?
Yeah, I called this one. On the other one, we sort of waited. Well, anyhow, here comes Mark Scheifele. And Scheifele fed it through. And it got the glass on the try that came from Haskins. Scheifele wheels again and steps back in. Then O'Reilly, then Haskinen, try for O'Reilly, and this might be a chance as it's nudged on ahead, and a breakaway forthcoming. No! It got through and hit the post on the try that came from Clayton Keller. Pulled and played on now to O'Reilly. Circles with Haskinen nearby and found him, then back to O'Reilly again. This is the fourth one of these three-on-three tournaments. The Central Division has never made it to the championship game. Pettersson across, oh, and what a save by Rene on a rifle shot.
I think it hit him right in the mask.
It sure did.
Scheifele scores! And it is 5-1.
I think Rene should get an assist on this. Back the other way, Pettersson with a beautiful pass over to Drew Doughty, off the head of Rene, and then O'Reilly shovels this puck up. And then here comes Mark Scheifele, the terrific young center iceman of the Winnipeg Jets, and little backhand, forehand shovel, Gibson down, Scheifele goes upstairs, and the Central has put up a five spot here in the first.
Landeskog moves on. Four goals in the last 2 minutes of play as this one is laid back down and Rene comes out to handle it. Watching that replay, do you think that was an intentional save by the helmet man?
Well, sometimes you don't have any other choice, Doc, to get the head in the way, but Doughty let that puck go. Right to the corner, fortunate bounce for the Central.
They slow it down for us, so it looks like there's more intent maybe than there really was. In front, Landeskog with a try there, but then it is booted back out again, rushed on by Connor McDavid. He's got Carlson with him, fed it across. No luck there.
Yeah, one too many passes there.
McDavid tried to sashay through, but it's taken away by Roman Josi.
That was excellent peso by McDavid and Carlson to put pressure on Pekarina.
Rantanen brings it on. Score! There is disgruntlement in the stands. It is 6-1, the Central.
And it doesn't help that John Gibson, a member of the Anaheim Ducks, one of the arch rivals of the Sharks, is in goal.
This All-Star game, get closer to the NHL's biggest stars with the NBC Sports app. Watch live on any device, get inside the action with all new technology featuring player and puck tracking. Download the app and find out more at nbcsports.com/live. This is continually viewed if you go to the app. This is fun. You're going to find out more than you've ever found out before. And this will be a fixture next season in all games. All 31 arenas will be outfitted with this technology. Bought ahead for a shot that's off the glove of Rene, and that came from the stick of Johnny Gaudreau. Led back across, but here's a two-on-one. Wheeler moving out with Kane. Wheeler stepping ahead, Pavelski is defending, and Kane has buried it, and it is 7-1. My goodness, and it's not even halfway through this first period.
These aren't garden variety goals either. These are spectacular goals being scored. Great passing with Wheeler and Kane. Look how quickly this puck is off Patrick Kane's stick when he gets it. Gets it broke.
It almost went right into the camera lens. Pass from Wheeler right over, no chance for John Gibson.
And this is the man in goal that has his team only 1 point out of the playoffs at this point in the season, and he has been more responsible than anyone, it seems to me, for their being that close. But it is Kane pivoting, over for Haskinen and back to Kane at 7-1 and 90 seconds to go in the first half of this game. Beat for Haskinen was blocked away. Johnny Gaudreau is able to hustle ahead. In a race, and Kane trying to get back. Gaudreau across. Oh, and what a grab there by Rene on Johnny Hockey. More changes for the Central. McKinnon is doing a wonderful job of coaching, isn't he?
He's got a little help from Paul Maurice, head coach of the Winnipeg Jets, in charge of the Central team.
One of the only coaches I've seen in the NHL coaching with coffee in his hand.
Relaxed. O'Reilly able to turn here and swing it back ahead. Mark Scheifele takes it on. And Scheifele right around behind. Fed one out in front. Good guarding done there. And then it's forced around behind. Drew Doughty doing the work defensively there from the Los Angeles Kings. Doughty able to steal it away, protects and controls. Elias Pettersson is out there with him, as well as Keller. And some sarcastic applause for John Gibson from this crowd here that is not necessarily friendly to Anaheim anyway, as has been pointed out. And the largest Bronx cheers have been greeted by smiles on both nights from Drew Doughty. Ahead now, bringing it on is Pettersson. Can't stop it by. And he's got a lot of moves, this rookie, as the horn sounds to end the first half of game number one. Pekka-Rinne sparkling. Faced nine, got eight. Seven-one Central after 10 minutes. The 2019 Honda NHL All-Star Game is brought to you by Dunkin'. Where there's hockey, there's Dunkin'. By GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. By the first ever Lexus UX, see your Lexus dealer. And by Discover Card, the official credit card of the NHL. Jeremy Roenick is here.
Thanks, Doc. I'm on the bench with Nathan McKinnon. You're getting a little bit of rubdown here from your guys here. You got Landeskog and Rantanen are playing pretty good, and you're out here. The guys are saying they don't need you.
I know. They got rid of the dead weight. They look great. I think Mikko's already got 2-1. Gabe, he wants to chip it in right now. This is a little bit over his element, but we're having a lot of fun. It's fun being behind the bench right now.
You got the guy right in front of us, Ryan O'Reilly, saying, listen, I can take your spot anytime. Is that true, Ryan? What are you giving some crap over here for?
Well, I think he's not that good of a coach. He's more of a player, but he's staying positive, which is nice. It's good to see him back there.
It's nice being an MVP candidate, though. Hey, keep having some fun out here, Nathan.
Thanks a lot, man. Appreciate it.
You don't have to prove anything to any of these guys. Back to you, Doc.
There is an MVP prize at the end of the day, and no one on either roster here has won before. Landeskog able to bring this one ahead, trying to get things going the other way. It's Josi shaking it across. Different goalies are in now. Marc-Andre Fleury in one net, Devin Dubnyk in the other for the Central. Fleury in the net to our right as they've changed. Brought back in by McKinnon. Or I beg your pardon, I have him on the brain, by McDavid. Rolled around behind. Ryan O'Reilly with three assists in the game, former teammate of McKinnon's, and Kane with two goals and an assist. And what a goal that one was, tucked in the top shelf. What a shot that time by Landeskog. Two goals for him.
Welcome to the game, Marc-Andre Fleury of the Vegas Golden Knights, and saw Nathan McKinnon there pretty happy that his teammate's coming back to the bench. Going top shelf on Fleury.
I just think that shot had so much velocity, Marc-Andre Fleury wasn't expecting that because he never moved, and that's usually one of his strengths as a goalie, his glove hand.
Was that McKinnon hand sign there? I'm just rolling the lines. Next group up. And he's short one player, and that's himself. Here's Kane giving it on over now to Blake Wheeler. Tried to shovel it through, but Burns said no. And then dropped on now for Kane, who's got Scheifele alone in front. Save made by Fleury. Scheifele sent it across. Nice chop there by Burns. Hoisted out by Gaudreau. Pavelski able to step back in. Burns recoils with a pass on the turning stick of Johnny Gaudreau. Gaudreau brought it on. fired one, and that shrugged away by Devin Dubnyk.
Pacific's got to get their heart rate up here a little bit. Down by a touchdown.
Shifley to Kane. Dragged it along, threw it out. Wheeler across, Shifley couldn't get it home. A nice stop there by Marc-Andre Fleury. Across now to Kane. They're just dangling on to Wheeler. To Kane. Wheeler, who will shoot? Nobody. Hoisted out is Pavelski. And he moves on in all alone on Dubnyk. Save made by Dubnyk. Long toss ahead, carried in by O'Reilly, looking for his fourth point. Lots of moves as he holds around behind. O'Reilly controls, fed it across Haskinen. Could not hold for a moment until he had to get more possession, and with that went away some time. But now it's O'Reilly moving on in, and a backhander is shrugged away by Marc-Andre Fleury. So now Burns delays for another change from his bench, and a steal, and O'Reilly. Score!
Ryan O'Reilly's having himself a heck of an all-star game to date. Bats that out of the air off the Brent Burns turnover. Knows Marc-Andre Fleury wants to be aggressive, and O'Reilly finishes it off.
Well, right before this, Joe Pavelski, the captain of the San Jose Sharks, goes post and out. And then he has another breakaway and tries to go top shelf, but the quick glove of Devin Dubnyk, the outstanding goaltender of the Minnesota Wild, denies Pavelski not once but twice.
Keller in front, Pettersson stopped by Dubnyk. Some strong goaltending for the Central. Again, looking for their first berth in the championship game. Keller to Pettersson, could not get it through Ryan O'Reilly. And so it is Josi, but then it's Pettersson. And then it is Keller, saved by the sprawling Dubnyk, fished out by Josi, and started on by Haskinen. Chased down by Josi. You notice the players are being identified. So I will sing something because I'm not needed to identify. No, you don't need me to sing. Here's Josi, beating one in front. Past that man, Heiskanen, M. Heiskanen, and it's a two-on-one the other way. Brought back by Pettersson, and a save made by Dubnyk. And Dubnyk fought that one off and then pushed it back into play and nearly got into some trouble. If there are any shots today that are over 70 miles an hour, they will be registered right underneath the clock, which shows time. Right now, you are seeing on the ice, and on is McDavid.
Made about four or five of those type of saves. Welcome to the game, Devin Dubnyk.
He's been in it right from the start.
Here's Kane dancing free through the legs on over for Rantanen, and he will chase this down with Carlson taking it away, and he will start on in. Off of Dubnyk and wide. He's unbelievable, this guy, and he's getting a lot of shots of quality. This one shanked back in, and Fleury directs some traffic there. Is going back is Connor McDavid. Brought on again by Carlson, and a save again made by Dubnyk. Goalies can be MVPs, you know. Landeskog has scored! A finesse move a la Peter Forsberg. And that is three. And it is 10. Connor McDavid, no less a player than he, with lots of moves. And Devin Dubnyk strikes back. 10-1 Central later in the game.
Hi, I'm Jay Baruchel.
And I'm America Ferreira.
Hope you're enjoying the match.
Hope to see you in theaters on February 22nd.
For our new film, How to Train Your Dragon, The Hidden World.
And now back to the game.
Thank you, Jay and America. Looking forward to that. 5:24 to go in game number one. The winner plays game number three. Each game is 20 minutes long. If there are any penalties, the power play is a minute. Johnny Gaudreau finessed his way in. Score! Yeah, Guy likes that one. wish the score were closer, but it's 10-2 now.
Well, the speed and the skill of Connor McDavid pretty apparent right here, working on Blake Wheeler. And then he senses that Johnny Gaudreau's coming right in, a little drop pass, and Gaudreau slices and dices through the defense and puts it by the stick of Devan Dubnyk.
So now you have the puck trade. This again, another fixture of high-tech hockey that we are showing you today. It was the All-Star Game in 1996 in Boston, when one of the first experiments with something electronic took place. It was Fox Tracks. There was a comet trail behind the shot, and there were also miles per hour, and of course the puck was enhanced with a color around it. Well, here is a trail behind the puck so that you can follow it a little better. Here's Burns with a shot, and that one steered wide. And of course, we've done some identification for you. If you want to see all of these tricks, just go to the app that we've been telling you about on NBC. And there is a magnificent thing done by Marc-Andre Fleury in goal. And now Carlson led it on a cross. Pavelski moves in. Carlson scores! 10-3.
Well, before that beautiful passing play between Pavelski and Carlson, watch this save by Marc-Andre Fleury. Right off the left pad. And then the San Jose Sharks go to work. Brent Burns moves it up the ice to Carlson. Little give and go, and a wide open net. I guess that's the only way you can beat Devan Dubnyk, at least here in the second half of the game. He has been sensational. Beautiful play there by Pavelski.
Burns has scored! The local heroes are stepping up now. 10-4. Two goals in 10 seconds.
Hometown crowd loving it, and Burns goes top shelf on Dubnyk. Seen a couple of the players from the Pacific try to go to that glove side, and nobody's been able to beat him. And then finally Burns skates one way and shoots back the other way.
Haskinen across, Josi there. Played back across by Rantanen, and here comes another opportunity. Carried in by Erik Karlsson. No! Rattled off the pipe! I didn't glance to my screen to see if it was over 70, but a nice poke check, and then a snow angel save is made by Dubnyk in goal. And then a rising shot by Burns wouldn't go.
And he wanted their heart rate up. It's up now.
Empty the boat. They've got only 3:22 to go, and they've got to make up a half dozen. Carlson across. That shanked into Pavelski. They're just playing all the Sharks now. Carlson swirls and lays this all the way back down so he can get a change in lines. Marc-Andre Fleury whips a long toss ahead. Dreisaitl to play it there. Led one that is speared and held by Drew Doughty. Steps along with it. Tried to step by Josi, couldn't do it. Dreisaitl yet again. Then Doughty wants to pull away with 2:50 to go. Stolen though, and outletted ahead, and here's Kane alone on a breakaway. Long toss ahead. That one blocked away from the reach of Dreisaitl by O'Reilly, and O'Reilly just steers it ahead, but Dreisaitl is able to start the rush back. Has Keller nearby. Dreisaitl finessed it through, and Keller's shot shrugged away, and it is Keller dropping it off. 2:22 to go. O'Reilly shuffled this one ahead. Kane moving back in near the end of a shift. Save again made by Fleury! And a long toss back down. Dubnyk comes out to take over.
What are the chances Kane gets another breakaway on this shift?
Before he gets to the bench.
Three for a dollar.
Landeskog to O'Reilly. To Kane. Thrown in front, but Fleury got his stick in the way of that one. O'Reilly able to spirit it back on. Landeskog takes over there. Dreisaitl turned it away, but right to Kane. Kane finesses and continues to go. Taken away from him, though.
Nice play by Dreisaitl on Kane.
And so it is Dreisaitl moving out as five other players have come to the bench, and an intercept there by the fresh Wheeler And Wheeler is able to step back in. Dreisaitl is the one guy that hasn't made a change yet. McDavid got in the way of that. Taken away by Scheifele and tucked across now to Wheeler. Open ice ahead for him, and so he steps right into it. Laid it across. Oh, and a great save there made by Fleury on Heiskanen. This is thrown back in front, and it ricocheted across, and it's McDavid taking over there. Long toss is knifed down by a high stick. And that rather apparent, but it's taken over by the Pacific and will be handled at center eventually by Pettersson.
Yeah, Scheifele that knocked that puck out of midair.
Directed on across now and right around for Goudreau, who floated one up high, and it goes out of play with 50.4 left in the game. And for the first time, the Central is going to get into the championship round. Never have done that before. Brent Burns, one of the unique characters, has a ranch in Texas with over 100 animals and reported recently that, in my book, he is the only player that I know that's been bitten by a cheetah. But before the game, he said, you know, they have a rather small head and it's a bite and release, so it wasn't really as bad as it could have been. Okay, here's Carlson to Burns. Oh, and what a shot and what a save made by Dubnyk, and another shot, the sprawling save made by Dubnyk that time on Carlson, and another shot that went wide. My goodness.
The shark attack.
To the last 25. No icing on this play, so Fleury with the long toss. All the way it comes to Burns. Laid it over for Pavelski. Settles it down, tried to play it, hopped in front. Burns is fought off by Dubnyk again. Played then by Pavelski around behind, out in front, Carlson. 3 seconds to go. That one is blocked away by Wheeler, and the Central has won it by a score of 10-4. Coming up on the Lexus Intermission Report, the PK Project Preview, top three goals of the first half, and Atlantic Metropolitan introductions. Devin Dubnyk stocked 16 of 19. A lot of goals scored, some spectacular plays, some smiles and handshakes after game one.
Welcome to the Lexus Intermission Report. Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer.
Entertaining high-scoring first game as you look at the West locker room. The Central team will be back on the ice for the championship in a little bit. They beat the Pacific 10-4 in the first game, with the Atlantic and Metropolitan divisions coming up next as we welcome you to the Lexus Intermission Report on All-Star Night here in San Jose. It's a weekend full of NHL big names, and one of the biggest in the league is Nashville Predators three-time All-Star defenseman PK Subban, who hosted his very own late-night talk show last night on NBCSN. And today, an all-new episode of his digital series, The PK Project, debuts as Subban takes viewers to some of his favorite restaurants in Music City.
All right. Lots of love at the cafe. Hey, guys, how are you?
Good,
good. Let's get the biscuit. Here they come, dude.
All right. Here's the famous biscuits. We've got peach, blackberry, and strawberry preserves, all homemade here as well.
Great. Now, I got a weigh-in on Monday. Is this gonna affect the weigh-in?
It just might.
That picture is just as stubborn as I am. There we go. Two Loveless, best restaurant in Nashville. Billy Ray Cyrus. And that's Miley Cyrus's dad, right? I've never been a mullet guy. Who knows, maybe traditionally, instead of a playoff beard, I can get the mullet going.
A lot of laughs, a lot of fun ahead. You can watch now on NBCSports.com and the NBC Sports YouTube channel. We come back, Catherine Tappan and Mike Milbury will get you set. Sidney Crosby, ready for game two between the Metropolitan and Atlantic. He's one of the three nominees for best goal of the year thus far. We'll have your voting results in a minute.
We welcome you back to San Jose and a look at Penguins captain Sidney Crosby, a three-time Stanley Cup champion, looking to lead the Metropolitan Division to a win here tonight in game number two. As we welcome you back alongside Mike Milbury, I'm Catherine Tappan. With the NHL on pause at the All-Star break, we wanted to take a look back at the top three goals of the first half of the year, and it's your last chance to vote. Sidney Crosby, Anthony Duclair, or Tomáš Hertl. Here's a reminder of the nominees.
gives it away to Hurdle, who skates out the center with it.
Hurdle barrels in now on Fowler.
Makes a brilliant move on Fowler.
Hurdle's in, he scores! What a goal!
A brilliant move around Cam Fowler.
That's a highlight reel goal, John, and it's only the first night of the season.
Quick pass to Duclair. He brings it back in, loses an inch, gets back onto his feet, turns it forward! And he scores! Oh my goodness! I do declare, it's a free throw!
Duclair ties it in spectacular fashion.
Across the line for Crosby. Chris Crosby with Broussard.
Now in the far circle is Crosby. He comes below the goal line.
But Nook in the corner still has it. Great move.
Cuts in on goal on the back end. And he scores! Unbelievable effort from Sidney Crosby.
What a goal by the captain.
Oh my goodness.
And the fans have made their vote, and it is Tomas Hurdle of the San Jose Sharks taking home the prize. Mike.
Jonesy was the one that was politicking for that, but I'm still going to stick with Crosby's goal. All very
all
impressive.
Of them incredibly impressive, and so much to look forward to in the second half of the season, but much more to get to tonight. Up next, we shift our attention to the Eastern Conference Stars, the Atlantic, against the Metropolitan Divisions. We'll bring it to you next.
Watching the Lexus Intermission Report. Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer.
It's time for Game 2. And now, the 2019 Atlantic Division NHL All-Stars. The Atlantic Division captain from the Toronto Maple Leafs, number 34, Austin Matthews. From the Boston Bruins, number 88, David Pastrnak. From the Buffalo Sabres, number 9, Jack Eichel. From the Buffalo Sabres, number 53, Jeff Skinner. From the Detroit Red Wings, number 35, Jimmy Howard. From the Florida Panthers, number 3, Keith Yandle. From the Ottawa Senators, number 72, Thomas Chabot. From the Tampa Bay Lightning, number 86, Nikita Kucherov. From the Tampa Bay Lightning, number 88, Andre Vasilevsky. From the Tampa Bay Lightning, number 91, Steven Stamkos. And from the Toronto Maple Leafs, number 91, John Tavares. Now, please welcome the 2019 Metropolitan Division NHL All-Stars. From the Carolina Hurricanes, number 20, Sebastian Aho. From the Columbus Blue Jackets, number 3, Seth Jones. From the Columbus Blue Jackets, number 13, Cam Atkinson. From the New Jersey Devils, number 21, Kyle Palmieri. From the New York Islanders, number 13, Matthew Barzell. From the New York Rangers, number 30, Henrik Lundqvist. From the Philadelphia Flyers, number 28, Claude Giroux. from the Pittsburgh Penguins, number 58, Chris Letang. From the Pittsburgh Penguins, number 87, Sidney Crosby. From the Washington Capitals, number 70, Braden Holtby. And from the Washington Capitals, number 74, John Carlson.
The 2019 Honda NHL All-Star Game is brought to you by AT&T. More for your thing, that's our thing. By Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. By Navy Federal Credit Union, our members are the mission. And by Honda, official vehicle of the National Hockey League. John Cooper, the coach of the Atlantic Division team, had an interesting way of determining his combinations. He put out a whiteboard and he had the players sign it as a souvenir for him, the coach. And then he presented it to them and showed them that the order in which they signed is the order in which they're gonna play. And because Andre Vasilevsky at the bottom signed ahead of Jimmy Howard, Vasilevsky will play the first 10 minutes and Howard will play the second. How about that? So it is Andre Vasilevsky who was impressive here in the skills last night. He himself has missed a month with a broken foot, but he's got a 925 save percentage, third best in the league. And Henrik Lundqvist was the goaltending star last night, 12 straight stops. The best last night, too short of Marc-Andre Fleury's record in the skills. Sixth winningest goalie in 102 years of NHL history, nine wins from fifth place. So we've had the Stanford band and drummers in goalie masks and wristbands with team colors for each player introduced. You probably noticed that they were changing color as each player came out. They've thought of a lot of things here today. And in the first game, we saw tons of goals. That is a tendency in the first two games, and then the game for all the money winds up being a lot tighter.
Yeah, $1 million on the line.
Todd Reirden, the coach of the Metropolitan Division, coach of the Washington Capitals, said that he was going to talk with Sidney Crosby. Of course, he was an assistant in Pittsburgh. And he was going to pair Crosby with Chris Letang, but he thought that Crosby would like to have the speed of Matthew Barzell on his wing. So that's probably going to be the way that would work. And then a U.S. National Team Development Program trio that would have Kyle Palmieri playing along with Cam Atkinson and also Seth Jones, two guys from the Columbus Blue Jackets.
How about Sidney Crosby, Doc, here, making a fan's day, and look what he does. He passes it to a Alexander Ovechkin fan, and that is just flat out awesome. Great job by Sid, and even though that young hockey fan's got an Ovi jersey on, who is not here, got a fan for life, no doubt about it on the inside.
And not 100% health, Pierre, in that he was not able to be in full bore yesterday, but there's one of Alex's favorites sitting in a front row seat.
Had a chance to talk to Sidney this morning during their skate, and he said that he's feeling a lot better. He got through whatever was ailing him and doing a lot better, and you see him smiling right there talking to Johnny Tavares.
That other unit for the Metropolitan will be Claude Giroux, Sebastian Aho, and John Carlson. But here, Barzell, and you see the pointers giving you the clue on who was out for the Metropolitan to start that game as Crosby wheels, moves on, and shoots. He scores! Crosby at 15 seconds of this first period.
Yeah, that was some Matador defense from the boys from the Atlantic, and Sidney Crosby made them pay early on.
And Steven Stamkos thought he was going to make the pass over to the wing there, and Crosby just kept it and went right down Main Street and blew it right by Vasilevsky.
John Tavares and Steven Stamkos are out there. Meanwhile, this is brought on by Crosby and laid on back for Chris Letang, and Letang dropped it off. Barzal doing what he can do so well, and that's just finesse and dazzle to the outside and work all around as he's doing now, and will have to be forced back out to center.
And against his old teammate with the Islanders, John Tavares.
It is Barzal holding. Tavares moved toward him, but now comes to the bench for the first change. First minute of play, game number two. Two 10-minute segments of this game number two, and the winner will play the Central for the million divided 11 ways. John Carlson led it ahead, can be dragged back on by Claude Giroux with Aho on the wing, and that wide rebound. Oh, and it ricocheted off the post and kicked on back across. Played back on now for a pass across to Carlson again. You notice the logos of the NHL teams are on front. Here's Giroux, and that one would not go. And away, and back down from Kucherov. Finessed on by Henrik Lundqvist. Kyle Palmieri able to escape and lay one ahead. Brought back on and given to Palmieri. Right across and a score! Seth Jones was driving to the net and mashed it in. It's 2-0 Metropolitan.
Well, the big defenseman for the Columbus Blue Jackets says one of his teammates out there, Cam Atkinson, gets it over to Palmieri and then rink wide over to Seth Jones, and those great soft hands. Throws it in between the post and the left leg of Vasilevsky.
That's a great commercial for USA Hockey right there. It shows speed, finesse, peripheral vision, and finishing ability from three guys, as Doc talked about, from the U.S. Development Program.
Lob back across. Jack Eichel has scored. And so the Atlantic is on the board.
Speaking of the U.S. Development Program, Jack Eichel, another product of that program.
Took only 8 seconds. So it is 2-1.
He wins a faceoff, and then Jack Eichel's going to stay onside, create some time and space for himself, go by Palmieri and put it right through the wickets of Henrik Lundqvist.
All you're trying to do there is get the goaltender to open up when you move that puck laterally, going from forehand to backhand. You let him open up the legs, and then you just slide it right in.
Brought ahead by Jack Eichel. It's over for Jeff Skinner, his teammate in Buffalo. David Pastrnak, the sharpshooter for the Boston Bruins, is out there with them. That one kicked aside by Atkinson and tipped on back, and it's Seth Jones. Looking ahead, and Palmieri is able to take this from the New Jersey Devils, but then blocked back out and can be carried ahead by Stamkos from Tavares. Stamkos with a backhander, and that one wouldn't go. Stamkos to the slot, though, and a shot. Oh, and that one gonged away by Lundqvist. He got his mask on that try. Delayed and carried ahead by Barzal. Picks up Crosby fresh from the bench, and also Letang. Crosby fed, that one shanked away, picked up there by Stamkos, led ahead and can be carried right back on by Tavares, and Tavares had it defended away, but Stamkos in front. Oh! A poke checked attempt from Lundqvist, but Stamkos stashed it by.
Watch the play by Steven Stamkos. He'll put this puck and his stick between his own legs and somehow finds a way to beat Henrik Lundqvist. Stick handles in front, and he puts this puck back through, and his stick puts it into the net. Yeah, he even trips himself, but you know what? Doesn't matter. Puck ends up into the back of the net.
The 291's going to work here for the Atlantic. Tavares and Stamkos, both of them have really picked up the pace of this game.
Letang takes his own pass, tried to shovel it across and got it to Crosby. Back to Letang again in this 2-2 game, and lots of dazzle already. Barzal tried to take it away and could not. Kucherov able to flip one ahead. Thrown back on by Thomas Chabot of the Ottawa Senators, and it's Austin Matthews able to take it around behind. Got it across now, but it's left behind by Chabot. Taken on by Crosby, knocked away by Matthews, given on to Crosby by Letang, and turned aside there by Vasilevsky. Can be played ahead now by Letang. Drips to the slot. Wide with the shot. Rebound off the boards, could not be nailed by Barzal, and so it is carried back up. A two-on-one developing Kucherov, but now coming across defensively Carlson, and Matthews tried to work his way by, but reaching out was Lundqvist. Pasternak able to give it across, and Kucherov walks it back in. Kucherov shoved it over. Matthews there. Pasternak tried to play it back across. No luck, and it can be carried back in by Claude Giroux on a breakaway. Protects and can't get it by the pad of Vasilevsky on the shift. Back the other way it is brought for a rocket of a shot that is saved by Lundqvist. What a try that time that came from Jack Eichel. Eichel up with it again. Stashed it around in front, and Skinner couldn't get it by Lundqvist. Time to time, there are great goaltending shows in this match. Aho drags it on, laid it across, and a save is made there by Vasilevsky on John Carlson. Am I shouting too much? It is Pasternak taking over there. We're getting some great opportunities, aren't we?
I'll give you a chance to breathe a little bit, Doc.
This is terrific. Here is Aho bringing it on. Wide with the shot. Carried back along, though. Nicely dragged by Barzal. Fed in front for Aho. I beg your pardon, that was Atkinson. A different 13. Can be carried back ahead now by a couple of 91s. Led back over now for Stamkos. Fed one around in front for Tavares, but that poked away as Lundqvist was there. Now along with this one, playing it as Yandel, couldn't get it through. Doubled back by Atkinson, has a fight on his hands though. It is taken in back out at center at Stamkos, settling it down and walking it right back in. Stamkos' pass is on to Yandel for a shot that is saved there by Lundqvist and handed aside. Long pass goes all the way back down. Vasilevsky there. Here comes Kucherov. Brilliant player for the Lightning, but he could not handle that as Palmieri reached out and knocked it away. Then a pass in front is wanded away there by the defense of Seth Jones. Austin Matthews of the Maple Leafs gives it on back to Kucherov, then on to Matthews. Matthews tries to finesse around behind and is able to circle behind and look over the traffic. Got it back across, but it was tipped away in a good reach by Atkinson. Near the end of a shift, they are. Meanwhile, this is Palmieri throwing it off the boards, and Atkinson is able to move back in. Atkinson crosses over, but he can't get it by Vasilevsky.
Good back check there from Chabot.
Tucked back over to Crosby by Letang, and he couldn't push it through Chabot. Crosby gave it to Letang, tried to hurry it in front. Now it's Matthews back the other way, and Letang trying to catch up to him. Matthews moving back in, getting a piece of it was Lundqvist. 2:50 to go in an entertaining first half of game number two. Moving in, and a shot went scorching wide by one of the 13. Help me, Pierre.
Barzal.
Thank you. Back over it comes now to Skinner. Walks back in and gives it over to Eichel. Fed one around in front, and that one wouldn't go. So it's back the other way, and it's Barzal walking it on. He's got Crosby out there and Letang with him. And circles and gives it on to Letang with Crosby near the net. The pass in the direction goes up against the glass. And they rule it had gone out of play. 2-2 in this contest. 8-7 Metropolitan, late in period one.
Want to stay up to date? Hey Siri, show me NHL standings.
So you see the faces of some of the best players in this league. competing for $1 million today, and there's pride on the line. You could almost play roller hockey in a parking lot, and these guys would compete hard. It is what they do, and it is what makes this game engrossing, especially when they get to the one at the end of the day. Thrown ahead now for Yandle to bring on. Keith Yandle fed it across. Stamkos retrieved. Looked for Tavares. Stamkos could not get by. Nudged ahead now for Sebastian Aho from the Carolina Hurricanes. Gave it over to the Flyers' Claude Giroux. And Giroux just circles and looks. Across to John Carlson. Then Giroux. But Aho. And must be played at center. And Carlson makes the play all the way back to Henrik Lundqvist.
Not just because the score is lower. Look out.
Oh, an intercept here. And Yandle moving in. Gave it across, but it was off the stick. That time off Tavares. And then it is carried right back in.
Going to say about the score. Seems like a little tighter checking in this game than it was in the first game between the Central and Pacific.
Here's Tavares bringing it back in. Tavares holding. Picks up Kucherov, gave it on over to Shabbat, and that one wouldn't go.
Good play by Seth Jones.
A couple of times now. Not shooting the puck.
Taken away and lifted back out and back down by Palmieri.
Atlantic team trying to be a little too cute there. Seems to be the norm when you get to these type of games.
42 seconds to go before we change ends and goaltenders. Kucherov turning with it there, dropping it on back to Shabbat. Couldn't get it to Kucherov. Laid back ahead by Seth Jones and carried right back on by Atkinson, who controls on in. And a pad stop is made by Vasilevsky. Trying to work his way on Kucherov, stolen away by Jones. He scores right under the crossbar, a roof shot. And it's 3-2 Metropolitan. A goal scorer's goal by Seth Jones.
Came out as quick as it went in, and the giveaway, you see the puck tracker. Puck should be going back the other way and ends up in the back of the net.
Second goal of the game for Seth Jones.
Goaltenders in this one had stopped 12 straight, picking up where they left off last night when they were forced to stop a bunch of breakaways. And these two goaltenders had the longest streaks of the night. Here's a chance in front of them. How on earth did that one not go in? But a great stop by Vasilevsky on Barzal at the horn.
See the reaction of Barzal after that? He can't believe that that puck did not get to the back of the net. Crosby and Letang setting up the table. Barzal looks like he has himself a wide open net, but the big left pad of Vasilevsky denies that man, Barzal.
In partnership with Parlay, Adidas is intercepting ocean-bound plastic and removing it from our coastlines. Together, we are giving plastic waste new life with the AdiZero Authentic NHL Parlay jersey, turning it from threat into threat.
A great partnership and a wonderful way to recycle plastic and other materials, and handsome jerseys they are. And here's more from Jeremy Roenick.
Seth, 3-2, got a close game, but an offensive outburst by you, two goals in that first period. How much fun are you having?
A lot of fun, a lot of fun. That's great for the fans here, and we're out here working and trying to win, so we're having a great time.
Talk about the competition that you guys are having here. Obviously, you're playing for $1 million, but we're also playing to have some fun. A little bit of bragging rights here too, right?
100%, 100%. We talked about it before the game. We're here to win, so we're going to work out here. We talked about back checking, and it should be a lot of fun here.
You got a hat trick coming?
I hope so. We'll see.
We're hoping so too. Way to go, Seth. Back to you, Doc.
He is the only multi-point player in this game. We had 9 in the first game. And I don't know if it matters to you. It is history, not prophecy, that the winner of the second game in the prior three All-Star games that 3-on-3 has been played has won the championship.
Did you hear him, Doc, at the end there? He said he is first ever.
I doubt that. Brayden Holtby is in the goal to our left for the Metropolitan. He of the Washington Capitals. And he faces a scramble, and he shut aside Jack Eichel. And at the other end, it is Jimmy Howard from the Detroit Red Wings. Barzal tried to drag through and could not. Laid back ahead, and here's Eichel breezing in on Holtby. Wide with the shot. Barzal able to take this back, and Skinner on him. Dropped on back to Crosby. Crosby drifting, tried to feed it in front, could not. And taken by David Pastrnak.
How about that defensive play by Jeff Skinner? Not easy to do against Sidney Crosby.
There are a lot of guys that become very committed. Here is Skinner trying to get in, and he put it off the crossbar. Did it go in?
I think it did, Doc.
Okay, under the crossbar then. And it becomes a goal that winds up getting this game tied.
Pastrnak to Skinner, and a little alley-oop. Move one way and just flip it back the other way, and
off the back bar.
Top shelf there for Skinner.
What a season he's had with the Buffalo Sabres.
Aho took the pass from Claude Giroux and rode the line before he gave it on to Carlson. And across now to Giroux. You see the players on the ice. Now that is dropped away. Long toss ahead, and here comes Tavares to break the tie. He scores! The Atlantic has taken the lead.
Really solid defense by the Atlantic. Forces a turnover, stretch pass onto the stick of John Tavares, and he's not going to miss from there at that backhand. Those soft set of mitts. Takes it and just deposits it in the top part of the net.
The last two goal scorers both coming into the All-Star game with 30 goals. Tavares of the Leafs and Skinner of the Sabres.
Pair of goals in 32 seconds. Cam Atkinson drags this one ahead from the Columbus Blue Jackets and the Metropolitan, looking for Jones, playing on, and Palmieri must play at center. On the turning stick of Atkinson, and the follow-up from Jones. Could not get by. Now it is Austin Matthews gliding in all alone on Holtby. Save made by Holtby. Looks for the long pass, and got it ahead to Atkinson, who protects, and now steps on, and circles. And across to Jones. Couldn't get it through to Palmieri because of Matthews. Jones fed one. Atkinson couldn't push it through. Then it's put in behind Howard and sent ahead now to Kucherov. Fans it out, and he's got Matthews to pass to. Behind the back to Matthews, and a save is made by Holtby. Palmieri able to escape the reach of Kucherov and hand it on to Atkinson, across to Jones. Jones to Atkinson, lost track of it, and then couldn't control enough because Howard was reaching out. So now it's Matthews on back with Kucherov again. More reinforcements for the Metropolitan coming from the bench, and a glove stop is made by Holtby. Long toss ahead, Crosby all alone from the red line in. No! Getting a piece of it, Howard. Crosby beats in front. Howard, another stop made on Barzal. Back for this one, Letang. But it's Skinner moving in. Pump check and a diving play by Holtby. Centering pass in front. Oh, and Holtby reached out as that one went flying, and his stick did too. Not the classic way a goaltender holds his stick. It's like a steel guitar. 4-3 Atlantic. NHL Tonight is live and on site, bringing you extended coverage from all the big events during All-Star Weekend and on NHL Network. We've been watching a lot of them during this week. A full crew out here just as the athletes have arrived and get a chance to see the resting players at the bench, including Andrei Vasilevskiy, who signed in first on the white erase board, and so he started. And Jimmy Howard, who was second to sign in, is the second goaltender who has taken over in a 4-3 Atlantic lead. Chasing this back is Jeff Skinner. Skinner able to push it back out. Eichel takes over there. Eichel lobbed it ahead. Here's Pastrnak. Save again, and two saves made in the control of Holtby. Now on comes Crosby. Crosby, a shot, he scores! A ripper! Second goal for Crosby, and the game is tied.
Well, the Pittsburgh Penguin connection hooks up Christopher Letang with a bullet pass to Sidney Crosby in full stride. He'll back the defender off, keep the arrow. Jack Eichel just snap it by Jimmy Howard. Quick release. And I don't think there's much Jimmy can do there. It just beats him on the short side, Eddie.
Yeah, most players will try to go to that far side, especially when you're on your offside. Crosby left-handed coming down those right-wing boards, and you'd like to try to go far side, stick side, but Crosby goes short side and beats Jimmy Howard.
Claude Giroux with this one, and a shot fought off there and covered. Jimmy Howard able to tend it and then hand it on for the long toss by Stamkos that is taken by Tavares. John Tavares brought it on, got it on to Stamkos. Across now, but that one broken up and can be played back up by Aho. Picks up reinforcements with Carlson in a 2-on-1. Yandel back, the feed, and Aho was able to steam it wide. And only that. Shuffled on by Carlson as far as Giroux. Aho able to work back in. Circles with it and drops it over for Giroux. Nicely sidestepped Stamkos. And then wheeled one over for Aho. 5.5 to go in the game, and it's tied. If it remains tied, there will be a shootout to determine who goes against the Central for the money. And the long toss will go back to Braden Holtby. This is flagged down by Kucherov, trying to work it ahead to Tavares. Able to escape, back pass. Kucherov couldn't get it by. Seth Jones able to hand it ahead. Palmieri moves up. He's got Atkinson in a 2-on-1. Palmieri holds and pushed it on through, and Howard made the stop there. Odd man rush developing the other way. Matthews gives it across. Shabbat brings it on. And,
offside. Austin Matthews.
Was that the second one of the afternoon, I think?
All of a sudden, they're going to call offsides.
Live from New York, it's Saturday Night Live with host James McAvoy and musical guest Meek Mill. An all-new Saturday Night Live later tonight on NBC.
And we saw the reaction of John Cooper, that coach of the Tampa Bay Lightning, head coach of the Atlantic team.
Derek Nansen, the linesman that made the call, he took it a little bit in the chin here after that call.
Rightfully so.
Pushed wide, now it is Seth Jones, but this is Kucherov, and he will have a two-thirds of the rink breakaway on Holtby. Shrugged away, lobbed one, and Holtby able to shrug that one away, and now it's the other way. Palmieri tipped across, and Cam Atkinson filtered it on back and out to get it. It's Holtby with the long return for Atkinson, defended there by Shabbat. He's got a winger up the wing, it's Barzal, and that would not go because it's Shabbat. And across by Letang. And taken by Jack Eichel. Leading point getter for the Buffalo Sabres. Leading guy and assists on that team. Plays it back over for Pastrnak. Pastrnak just pivots and drops it back over to Eichel once more. Could not get through, and so it's a breakaway here for Chris Letang. Hustling one ahead. Letang scores! 3:38 to go in the game, and it is now 5-4 Metropolitan.
Oh, high fives all around for Chris Letang. He's the one that's been sending out his teammates out with those great passes. He fakes it on a forehand and then goes right to the backhand, and Howard goes down and Letang is able to elevate it up and over the right pad of Jimmy Howard.
Great display of strength, not just with the hands, but with the skating, pulling away from Eichel. Not easy to do.
And Eichel kind of broke his initial concentration there with the quick little stick, and then the fake shot, and all in one motion of patience to throw those hands up towards the bar and put it into the back of the net.
You see the distance recorded there underneath the player names. The IDs, of course, are the names of the players, and that especially helps when you have multiple numbers that shoot the same way as we have in the dark jerseys with the 13.
I think if I had that, Doc, it would say not very far. Talked about the distance. I was going to go not very fast. Well, we already knew that, but
just get to the front of the net. You're good at that.
That's it. They don't ask how.
Played on back by Aho, fielded there by the goaltender whose team is in the lead right now in Holtby. Carlson hands it across. Aho brings it on, under 2.5 to go. Aho led it back over. Claude Giroux took over there. Philadelphia emblem on his chest. All teams wearing their own emblems, not the NHL, for the first time in the history of the All-Star Game. This played back over and can be carried right back up ice again as walking it on is Stamkos. Stamkos led it over, and that one is gloved away by Holtby on the try by Tavares. And here comes Giroux all alone on Howard. Lots of moves, can't get it by. Holds on though and fed one for the score by Aho.
Well, one of the young great players in the National Hockey League is Sebastian Aho of the Carolina Hurricanes. And beautiful pass here from Claude Giroux. You talk about an all-around player. Had a great conversation with the former general manager of the Carolina Hurricanes, the great Hockey Hall of Famer, the great Ron Francis, and speaks so glowingly of that man right there that the future is going to be very, very bright. That young player at the helm there in Carolina.
No icing on this play. Howard has to wait for it to cross the trapezoid line before he could do anything, and did a good body block there against the boards to keep Palmieri from getting there. Let's see if we have a goalie pull here in the last minute and a half with the deficit being 2. Now out in front is Matthews. Couldn't get it by. And it is Jones dropping it off. Palmieri took over there.
Sorry,
he's trying. He's trying to get it. He's doing a television interview with Hockey Night in Canada, who's also doing the game north of the border. And he's waving at his goaltender, Jimmy Howard, for the extra attackers you talked about, Doc, a couple of seconds ago.
That might have been a chance had Howard come off for Holtby to try to score, something that hasn't happened in an All-Star game for a goalie score. Here is Howard off, and there is a pass ahead, and the net is empty, and it is Atkinson blasting it home.
He's John Cooper is blaming Hockey Night in Canada, saying, you told me to make the call. Oh, that's great. Well, John Cooper calls Jimmy Howard out. Austin Matthews going to turn the puck over. Crosby moves the puck up. And Cam Atkinson, he just wants it to be in the hardest shot competition.
That was probably about 55 miles an hour off the stick.
For the hat trick, that was Crosby, and it went up against the glass. And so the Metropolitan will face the Central in the last game here. Pasternak in front, spirited away by Barzal, and it's 2-0. Penguins moving in, and who would take the last shot? It would be Letang, and then Crosby, waiting and trying for Barzal. But ahead with this now is Pasternak with 8 seconds to go. Glass. Paddled away by Holtby, who is the goaltender of record here, coming on when that was up for grabs. And so 7-4 Metropolitan, they will face the Central for the money. Coming up on the Discover Card Intermission Report, That goaltender, Braden Holtby, with Mike Tirico. BB Rex's live performance. And a preview of what it will be like when the Metropolitan goes up against the Central. A total of 46 shots on goal and 11 goals. We've had plenty of those. The average goals in the championship game total in the past, 5.
Welcome to the Discover Card Intermission Report, presented by Discover Card, the official credit card of the NHL.
Good work between the pipes by that man, Braden Holtby, helping the Metropolitan win the second game. They'll take on the Central for that $1 million winner team take-all final coming up here in a little bit as we welcome you to the Discover Card Intermission Report. So much of this weekend is about the offensive stars, but when we turn back to the regular season and the push for the playoffs, you know, your team's not going very far without great goaltending, something Washington got last spring from the aforementioned Holtby. We sat down with the All-Star yesterday to relive the Capitals' Stanley Cup odyssey.
It was one of the more intriguing runs in any sport in a while.
The Washington Capitals, for the first time in their 44-year history, are the Stanley Cup champions.
Let's start with the hurdle of Pittsburgh. Getting over that hump, what was the most important part to you for you guys being able to win that series?
Man, it's so close. One bounce here, one bounce there. It goes completely the opposite way either way. You know, maybe we win the series 2 years ago, or
sure.
You know, maybe they win last year if they get a couple other bounces.
The demons have been exorcised!
After being Pittsburgh, I think we just felt like we were playing with house money. We were just playing free and giving it everything to see. And that game six that we played was the best hockey game I've ever seen the Washington Capitals team play.
Only four prior goaltenders have had shutouts in game six and seven in history, and Braden Holtby has done it.
Does a day go by that someone doesn't come up to you and ask about the save in game two of the final?
When I go into hiding or something, but no, it's obviously a pretty special moment.
Oh, it didn't go!
You know, you go through process then that moment of where a player should shoot that, and you just hope he shoots it there, and luckily he did.
What a save! The save of the series!
In Washington, they'll be calling this the save!
I don't know if you've seen this on social media the last few weeks. They've been doing this 10-year challenge. So here is the 2019 Braden Holtby, and here's 2009. Tell me about this guy.
I think I've put on a few miles since then.
Good miles.
Yeah.
Miles, that got your name on the cup.
Yeah, that's true.
Could you have imagined then what's happening in your life now?
It's been different than I would have probably thought it was then, but it's been rewarding.
People probably like seeing you without the beard here. They didn't know that there was a face under that under that beard.
I'm a little more grizzled now, I guess.
You could only pick one moment to have in that big picture over the fireplace so you could look up and say, that's what it was all about. What would it be?
Wow. You know, a picture of with us at the parade, our team, and you see the joy on our face and the joy in that city. That was pretty special to change the mood of one of the most powerful cities in the world. That was pretty cool.
Pretty cool reflection for a pretty good goaltender in Holtby with Mike Milbury. Mike, there's always that Stanley Cup hangover. It's hard to get refired up. Right now, they're only 3 points behind the Islanders, but they hit their roughest patch coming into the All-Star break. Look ahead here for the Caps.
Well, looking ahead, I'm looking at right now, Mike, because I think this is the perfect time for them to have a long break. They don't play until they face Calgary, and that'll be a tough challenge. What really has to happen for the Washington Capitals is to make sure that they get back to the game that they played in the late parts of last year and in the playoffs. They played with discipline. They played intelligently. They need to infuse that into the locker room. The coach needs to take responsibility. The players need to accept it, and they need to exhibit it in their stretch run here. There's still plenty of time for the Washington Capitals to clean up their act, but clean up their act, they have to.
And Holtby said it is very difficult to defend the title. We saw the Pens do it, Washington trying to do it. You'll see Boston play Washington next Sunday, Super Bowl Sunday, our game of the week here on NBC. Mike's back with Catherine Tappan in just a moment, and a live musical performance from Grammy Award-winning artist BB Rexha. That's coming up as we continue on this All-Star Saturday night in San Jose.
The NHL and SAP got together yesterday to announce the results of their latest venture. They have created an NHL Coaching Insights app for the iPad. The app will provide coaches real-time customized data and a player statistics during the game. Features will include player time on ice, and face-off win-loss percentage in real time. As we welcome you back inside SAP, we're getting set for the final. It'll be the Central Division against the Metropolitan Division. Gabriel Landeskog of the Colorado Avalanche had a hat trick in the first game, and he is standing by in the locker room with JR.
Thanks, Catherine. Pretty good first game. Hat trick. Having any fun? And did you expect a hat trick in the first game?
No, I certainly didn't expect that, but we're having a blast on our bench, and boys let loose, and we want to win this thing.
So you have you and Rantanen, but your centerman is not there, and I think your centerman's getting he's getting a hard time from everybody. So have you said anything to him during intermission here?
To be honest with you, we're working some trades behind the scenes. We don't need him anymore, so we might get something back for him. So
I think he's feeling a little left out over there. He's hanging out real close to you to make sure that you guys stay positive with him.
Yeah, he's just standing on the bench drinking coffee all game, just yelling at us and telling us to move the puck and skate and all these things, but he went from being a captain to an assistant coach real quick, but he's been good.
Talk about this final game. How motivated are you to go out there and have a good game and take away the money, but just for bragging rights right here?
Oh, absolutely. I like playing with these guys. It's been a lot of fun and getting to know everybody, and while we're here, we might as well try to do what we can to win.
Have some fun.
Yep.
All right, Catherine, back to you.
All right, JR, thank you very much. The Central Division also featured a tremendous line that was with Patrick Kane on it, Mike, but you can never go wrong with Patrick Kane there.
Absolutely. They played with Blake Wheeler and Scheifele, and those guys were terrific. Kane in particular, although I think he could have had 10 goals in that one session, was just dazzling. He just controlled the puck all night long, and I think we're going to see more of that. And always dangerous Patrick Kane just seemed to be loosey-goosey and having as much fun as anybody. Look at the pass there and all smiles, and why wouldn't it be if you can play with this guy? But you never know what he's going to do from one shift to the next. But playing with those two guys from Winnipeg, he sure looked like he was comfortable and relaxed. Lots of things to worry about, however, from the other guys, especially a guy by the name of Crosby.
Yes, indeed. But let's hear what Patrick Kane has to say going into the final. He's with JR.
Thanks, Catherine. Patrick, Mike's up in the booth right now saying they're having a lot of fun, a lot of smiles, nobody knowing what you're going to do. Do you even know what you're going to do out there every time you touch the puck?
I don't know. I guess you do a little bit based on maybe what's worked in the past a little bit, but I think this game is so fast now, you just try to play off instinct, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
I'm seeing a little bit of everything from you out there. Assists, goals. You even had a back check. You skated as fast as I've ever seen you in an All-Star game. What's up with that?
First ever back check in All-Star history right there. Mark it down. But Central was struggling for a while. We were 0-3 our last three games, so it was nice to get a win.
It's just being a leader, right? Showing these guys how to handle the All-Star game.
I'm the veteran now, so.
Go get the win, Patrick.
All right, thanks, Sheriff.
Back to you, Catherine.
All right, JR, thank you very much. The most All-Star appearances here this weekend is from Patrick Kane with 8. You look at the other side, though, you've got a guy named Sidney Crosby, as you mentioned, Mike, with that Metropolitan Division.
Yeah, he comes off the sick bed and shows up and starts scoring goals and making things look easy. I mean, this guy is a world-class leader, world-class player, and now is more than ever seems comfortable in his role.
17 goals scored between the Central Division and the Metropolitan Division, and $1 million on the line as we get you set for the final here in San Jose at SAP Center. Henrik Lundqvist getting set to take the net.
You've been watching the Discover Card Intermission Report, presented by Discover Card, the official credit card of the NHL.
The 2019 Honda NHL All-Star Game is brought to you by Sprint. Switch today. By Bridgestone. Tires built to come through in the clutch just like NHL players. By Mass Mutual. Live Mutual. And by Volkswagen. Don't just get an SUV, get an SUVW. That's the mascot game, and they all pose for a nice team picture afterwards. Take a look at the player profile with insights from SAP. There's a bit of a clue, but it is a young circuit that we have here. Look at the first point leader, Nikita Kucherov, 25. And you see a 22-year-old, a 25-year-old, a 22-year-old tied for third in Goudreau and McDavid. And then Nathan MacKinnon tied for fifth, though injured, 23 years old. And look at the beard that grew very fast on Patrick Kane. He did cut it off today for the game at age 30 and appearing in number 8.
Well, Doc, we have great access inside the locker room in the All-Star game. And I was talking with Patrick Kane inside the locker room, and then Paul Maurice came in, and he actually introduced himself to Patrick Kane and said, hey, look, here's the way it's going to be. My two guys, Wheeler and Scheifele, are going to start this game. You're the guy that has the most seniority here in this game. You want to start with him? And he said, yes, sir. And so far, so good for Paul Maurice and Patrick Kane and the Central Division getting ready to play in the championship game against the Metropolitan.
Henrik Lundqvist, who was sparkling in his first game and also last night, has worn a smile throughout this weekend and has been so gracious as usual, is going to get the start in the championship game. And just judging from what we're seeing across the way, it looks as though Devin Dubnyk will be the guy who will start for the Central, in that the other two goaltenders were busy having a nice chat along the red line. So Dubnyk will be starting in goal. There you see Pekka Rinne. And Rinne will take over the last 10 minutes. Two 10-minute periods.
Yeah, and $1 million on the line for the winning team.
Those are our Honda starting goaltenders. And these guys were all very solid in the first game. Why they are here. Sidney Crosby's unit will start with Matthew Barzell and Chris Letang. Unlike in the first game, they're wearing lighter jerseys, but with the crests of their home teams on the front.
Good looking jerseys. Beautiful.
And I mentioned earlier, this is the first time in the history of the All-Star game. Well, that's incorrect. If you go back into the earlier era of games when the defending Stanley Cup champion wore their normal uniforms to compete against the rest of the league and All-Stars. But in the recent vintage, this is different. And great. And ahead now is Letang, pivoting away from Blake Wheeler. It is Kane and the two Jets. Barzell could not shake that one through. But then to the outside, Crosby got it onto Letang. Dish back to Barzell. Barzell a shot. He scores! And it's 1-0 at 22 seconds. Barzell's first goal of the day is there.
Well, that line scored in 15 seconds into the semifinal game. It was Crosby from Barzell, and there the terrific young superstar of the New York Islanders gives the Metropolitan Division a early 1-0 lead on the Central.
Great All-Star weekend. Chris Letang, by the way, he's been an assist machine and a scoring machine.
This is fed back across from O'Reilly and is dropped back off by Landeskog and taken on by Rantanen. Ryan O'Reilly just waiting and dishing back over. Landeskog pivoting. An opening. Circles around behind. Watched there defensively by Barzell. Fed back over to O'Reilly again. Dished off for the feed in front. Oh, what a great stop made by Lundqvist. What a stop made that time on Rantanen. And back the other way, it's brought by Barzell. Tried to feed it across. It was tipped away from Letang, but he regathered. Letang circling now. Led on back. Barzell takes it. Worms his way along, and that canceled out. And a great play made by Dubnyk. Carried on back now by Landeskog. Doubles back.
That was a heck of a stop. Barzell looking for his second of the game. That was the right pad. That denied Barzell an opportunity.
Josi brings it back in again and tried to feed it through. Carlson blocked that with his skate. Heiskanen played it out in front, but now it's Finesse back out to center, and charging ahead with this is Claude Giroux. Looks behind him and fired one. Save Dubnyk. Rebound, he scores! Claude Giroux has made it 2-0 Metropolitan.
Not very often you see a shooter on a breakaway get an opportunity to get his own rebound, but that's exactly what happens from the man they call G in Philadelphia. Beautiful stop there initially by Dubnyk, and the captain of the Flyers gives his team a 2-0 lead here with $1 million on the line.
As soon as he scored, he came to the bench. He goes, change right away. I'm out of gas. We got to keep this rolling.
longest tenured pro athlete currently in Philadelphia. Palmieri a shot, and getting a piece of that was Dubnyk, and then it bounced around for Palmieri, but it was played by a high stick, and so play is stopped.
How much chatter going on down there, Pierre?
On both benches a lot, but obviously not between the benches, but a lot of lively chat on the Metropolitan bench. Giroux's part of that.
Fed across now for Josi, and that blocked away by Henrik Lundqvist. Worked to the outside by Kane. Patrick Kane doubles back and fires, and that one wouldn't go. And then poked along by Heiskanen, but then it can be started out in a three-on-one that is lugged on by Palmieri. Kyle Palmieri just delays and fed it across, and driving to the net was Jones. Might be an odd man rush the other way. In a day off, though, carried ahead by Kane. Slows down and tucked it on back. Heiskanen a little backhander, and that one would not go through.
Henrik Lundqvist has looked so comfortable this entire All-Star weekend. Just amazing.
Letang doubles back. Wheeler and O'Reilly are out there now with Mark Scheifele for the Central Division. Barzal with Letang and Crosby, and that one tipped up to the glass as Crosby gliding by the front. Now Letang with it. Letang with a shot, and that one would not go. Can be played on now to the outside by Barzal and handed on over to Crosby. Crosby, nice finesse move. Dealt it on back. Letang with a shot. It was wide. Rebound back to Crosby. Finessed it around behind for Barzal. Sweep there. Failed from Dubnyk to the outside Crosby. Crosby threw one in front, and Dubnyk got his stick on that. Barzal yet again. Forced on by Crosby. Taken by Barzal in this 2-0 Metropolitan lead. Letang a shot. Score! And it's 3-0.
How about that deception, Eddie, by Christopher Letang? As Doc likes to say, brilliant conception of a play. Watch Letang. He's going to look like he's going to give it to Crosby. Look, look, look. And the no-look shot just fools Devan Dubnyk.
Oh, watch the move here by Crosby a little bit earlier in that shift. Backhand to the right skate, trying to make a play back to Chris Letang. And incredible skill level.
6:20 remaining in the first half of the championship game, 3-0 Metropolitan. Let's take a look at our Honda hero, the first woman to compete in the NHL skills, Kendall Coyne Schofield. A magnificent performance, and look at the reaction of other athletes after seeing that. The NHL donated $25,000 each to the charities of the choice of the American and Canadian women's national team players who participated in the demonstrations leading up to Friday night's NHL All-Star skills. Because there were athletes that had to show all of the various things that were going to be going on so that they could be learned. And they were extremely helpful in all that process. And then Kendall learned that she was going to actually participate. Ahead with this now, and taking it on is O'Reilly. O'Reilly just drifting further and throwing it behind. Mark Scheifele drifts further and hands on now to Wheeler. Wheeler delays, dishes off to Scheifele. Scheifele tried to push it along, and no luck because of Lundqvist again. Yanked along by Carlson, sped along, and O'Reilly darts after it. Right on him is Giroux, and Giroux is able to emerge and lay a pass ahead that's just too far for Carlson, and charging out to play this is Dubnyk, and he's able to force it along, and a shift change is on now for the Central. Tossed on, but off the stick of Wheeler, and he'll retrieve. Cam Atkinson out there drifts away defensively, and so handling this now is Brown. Then along it can be taken up the boards. Rantanen dropped it on back for his teammate in Colorado, Landeskog. Landeskog able to step out in front. Dishes it back off with a shot by Kane that's tipped aside by Seth Jones. And pumped around behind, and Jones will take over there.
They actually lifted his stick to make sure that it wasn't broken after he blocked that shot from Kane.
Kyle Palmieri back onto Cam Atkinson. Nice poke of the puck there, though. Outletted by Landeskog and carried on by Kane. Patrick Kane just delays and shoots. Oh, and that off the outside of the cage. And then played again by Kane. Thrown around in front and it ricocheted across. Atkinson can start back out now. Laid it ahead for Jones, who escapes up the wing. Jones protects. Oh, gets to the front. Taken out of the play. And what's the call? Penalty shot.
Dean Morton makes the call on a penalty shot.
That's it. Third penalty shot in the history of the All-Star Game, and there has not been a goal scored on one before.
Hopefully Seth Jones is okay there, colliding into the left post. Then behind Devin Dubnyk. Everybody's breath was held in Columbus after seeing that collision.
So here he goes, one-on-one against Dubnyk. No! And we remain at 3-0.
Once he started stick handling, and as soon as the puck went on edge, he had no chance to settle it back down. And Devin Dubnyk had him the old way, and a little talking coming from the blue paint with Dubnyk and Jones.
Speaking of talking, Sidney Crosby and Seth Jones were talking before Jones took the shot, and Jones said, "What do I do?" And Crosby said, "Just take your time and relax." He might have been too relaxed already.
He was, but the puck was not. Barzal moves ahead now and hands it on back. Letang, nice finesse move. Oh, and a shot that rang off the pipe.
Oh, it's in now. They're saying it went in.
Okay.
Well.
Letang with the move in the high slot. I think you're right, Doc. The officials started pointing right away. Yeah, clearly off the crossbar. You're exactly right, Doc.
Nice to have that once in your life.
No ball on the play, the puck did not cross the line.
Sidney Crosby was actually helping the officials. He knew it was no goal right away. He said no goal as he came by the bench. And now Nathan MacKinnon yelling Crosby. Now there's a little chatter.
So it is Barzal taking over here, dropping it on back, Letang. Barzal once again, watched there by Roman Josi from the Nashville Predators in this championship game. Brought back ahead, and it's Letang. Barzal dropped it off, Crosby took over. 3-0 Metropolitan. The million gets divided 11 ways. Shipley moving in. Handed it across, and it's pushed aside by Henrik Lundqvist. With MacKinnon having a less than active role for his team, you wonder if it's divided 10 ways if Central wins. Oh, Shipley with a strong shot and a pad stop there by Lundqvist.
Another beautiful stop by the King.
I mean, he is drinking coffee, but he is directing the team, so I think that qualifies him for a share, does it not? Here's a shot that went wide.
Murphy gets a little bit of a different appreciation standing behind the bench as a coach now.
This is drifted ahead by Josi, and then a nice poke there, but it comes on to O'Reilly, but he could not control, and John Carlson could. Drop back over for Carlson to bring further. Claude Giroux takes the pass from him. Looks over the traffic and connects with Sebastian Aho of the Carolina Hurricanes. Button hooks there and hands back to Giroux. No particular hurry at this point. 2 minutes and 22 seconds away from the end of the first half of the championship game. A fresh set of goaltenders and a change of ends. And the players wind up changing jerseys, though they don't change colors of jerseys. Presumably, those wind up being dealt away online. Here's Giroux with a rising shot that got the glass. Seth Jones able to bring this right back ahead and gain the zone. Fresh troops coming from the Metropolitan bench. Tripped up on the play with Jones, but the follow-through becomes a goal for Palmieri. 4-0 Metropolitan.
What a beautiful move by Seth Jones. Look at this move. Recognizes that's a forward. Gabriel Landeskog skating backwards, and then the follow-up by Palmieri as a wide open net as Jones and Dubnyk collided just outside the blue paint after the move from Jones.
Skill personified, not just Palmieri finishing into the yawning cage. He played that off his skate to a stick at a high rate of speed.
Here's Wheeler. He's got a man up the wing. Rantanen fires one that's gloved out of the air in a big sweeping motion by Lundqvist, and the long toss careens over to Kane. One back on by Rantanen. Nice move to get in front. Rang it off the pipe. And then Jones cleared it back down, and this will be taken by Dubnyk.
Central had 10 in their semifinal game. They're still looking for their first in the first half of the championship game with $1 million on the line.
They fired 6 shots on goal that have been stopped by Lundqvist. A couple of 10 bellers. Popped up in front and kicked and controlled, and this is a 3-on-0, but one was going to the bench, so it's a backhand try that does not work for Barzal. Now to the outside, it's Letang thrown in front. Barzal tried to play it in front again, and that didn't work. The initial 13 was Atkinson. The second one was Barzal. Both right-handed shots. Doesn't matter, I'm sure to you, but it does to us. Along to the outside now, it is Kane. And Kane drifting further. Gives it on now to Rantanen. Played it on to Kane. And Kane fed one in front that kicked back over to Barzal. Dropping back defensively is Josi with 8 seconds to go in the period. The drop pass comes to Crosby, and Crosby shot one. He scores! And it is the Metropolitan by a fistful, and the third for Crosby.
Well, Matt Barzal, Sidney Crosby have instantaneous chemistry. Watch Crosby just freeze Devan Dubnyk right there. Dubnyk thinks it's going to be a pass. No, it's a shot, and he blows it right by him.
And that is the end of period one of two. So 10 minutes for the Central to make up 5 goals. Shots were 11-6 Metropolitan in those first 10 minutes. Some fancy, fancy moves. And some were canceled by goalies, but not all. 5-0 after one. All right, what do we got on the card there, young man?
Oh, Monday 7 Eastern, NBCSN. The Winnipeg Jets will be in Philadelphia to take on the Flyers. Tuesday, Flyers will be in New York to take on Henrik Lundqvist and the Rangers. And Wednesday night hockey, Tampa Bay will be in the Berg to take on the Pittsburgh Penguins. Let's go down to ice level with JR.
Thanks, Edzo. I'm here at Chris Letang. It's just not fair. You, Sid, and Matthew Barzal, you're not even letting the other team touch the puck. It's unbelievable.
The game plan is to give it to Matthew. Obviously, we played against him in the season, and he just controls the whole game on his skating abilities and his skills. So that's the game plan right now for our line.
You guys look like the Harlem Globetrotters, you know, passing it back and forth. Obviously playing with the best player in the world is not a bad thing, but what's the game plan here in the third period? You got a 5-goal lead.
Just make sure we don't force anything. And when we have a chance to score, we have the weapons. So we'll give the puck to the right guys.
Well, obviously when you guys are on the ice, the other team's not touching it, but way to go. What a performance for you guys in the first period.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Good luck. Back to you, Edzo.
Thanks, JR.
Braden Holtby, 11 out of 13 in the semifinal game. And at the other end, Pekka Rinne, 8 out of 9 in the semifinal game. Barzal drops off for Crosby to provide the first test. Letang threw it in front, and a pad stop is made by Rinne. These guys tend to score quickly at the beginning of frames, and it's around in front for Crosby. Finesse free, but could not control, because right there to charge ahead with it now is Wheeler. Wheeler gains the zone, wants to pull off, and does, and gets it on for Heiskanen. And then along for Wheeler. then Letang, then ahead to Crosby, looks ahead for Barzell. That one bounced free and is corralled by Haskinen from the Dallas Stars. Crisply ahead for Wheeler. Dropped it back off for Haskinen, then over to Wheeler again. And sort of bounced away from what looked like sure possession for Letang, taken on by Scheifele. Now, normally it is Patrick Kane who is playing with these guys, but it's a two-on-one now. Aho gives it to Letang, to Aho, and a piece of that was the paraphernalia of the goaltender, Rene. Right back ahead comes O'Reilly. Across now for the carry-on, and the shot score! It's Landeskog! A productive day for him, and his team is finally on the board.
Well, a 2-on-0 at one end, Letang and Aho. A big save by Rene, and then O'Reilly, Landeskog goes stick side on Braden Holtby in the Central Division. Gets on the board and tried to catch Rene in between.
Claude Giroux with a drive, and then stopped by Rene. O'Reilly tries to outlet Carlson in the way, but now it comes on for Patrick Kane, who drifts in all alone. With the shot
and a wide open side there. Braden Holtby was off his angle and Kane just airmailed it up and over the net.
Here is Kane handing it on back to O'Reilly. A little bit of line changing done here, but it by necessity because they are one player short with the injury to McKinnon. Brought ahead now for the carry by Carlson. Finesse free by O'Reilly, but regathered by Carlson. Four goals on the afternoon and evening for Landeskog. Long toss ahead can be carried on by Kane. Kane just drifting with it now. And a shot is snapped out of the air and paddled ahead by Holtby. With great authority by him, it is Atkinson pivoting off. Atkinson just curls and gives it over. Oh, and the try in front by Seth Jones to connect with Palmieri was just off. Dragged on now by Rantanen. Rantanen with a shot, and that is nicely cradled there by Holtby and can be started back up by Jones. Headmans to Palmieri. Moves up with Atkinson, can't get it through. Landeskog moved it on to Rantanen. Has a trailer on the play in Josi, and Josi is able to accelerate and get it over to Rantanen, but he couldn't pull the trigger on a good shot. And so it's just jammed all the way back down for Rene. Haskinen with a pass ahead. Josi takes over there. Couple of defensemen out now for the Central. And around for a shot that would not go as Holtby interceded there on the try that came from Rantanen. Rantanen yet again. Floated it behind. Josi takes over there. Haskinen drifts. Would not work on the short side. And then along for Josi. Josi fed one in front. Score! It's 5-2 on the goal from Rantanen.
With $1 million on the line, the Central trailing in the second half by five have now scored two with 6:35 left to go here in the second half. Josi to Rantanen. We got ourselves a game with $1 million on the line.
Cast your vote for the 2019 Honda NHL All-Star MVP by visiting at NHL on Twitter. The four players on the ballot are these.
You get a write-in?
You don't.
You should.
No, I know. I can
Chris
think
Letang.
Yes.
For sure.
Right.
Write him in there.
And with some of the goalie performances here today, you can't have a goaltender either. Well, let's get together here and do something. I guess we can. We're powerless. Here's Wheeler and a back pass that came from Scheifele, and it's dragged on by Crosby. It is those above us who are making the selection, and so we have no say. Here is Barzell trying to float one in front, regathers. Thrown there for Crosby, he directs it in! And Crosby has scored once more. It is 6-2, Metropolitan, the fourth goal of the day for Sid.
And what a beautiful pass by Chris Letang. Barzell to Letang, and all Crosby's got to do, and that's not easy to do.
is redirect this puck, but to position the stick blade and angle it in off of Pecorine. Brilliance there from Crosby, and perfectly placed pass there from his teammate in Pittsburgh by Chris Letang.
Here's the feed back to Giroux. Giroux over for Aho, but through him. I think we spotted ref cam there pointing to the net just a moment ago. Here's O'Reilly moving in. That one went across the net, mouth wide, thrown back up by Giroux, but cut off neatly by Josi and handed across. Right back to Roman Josi again, able to stagger his way by one. Then laid back over, and O'Reilly with a shot that wouldn't go. Rebound, score! And so it is 6-3.
I think it was O'Reilly that got that one there, Doc. Metropolitans turned it over. The Central finds a way to get it to three. Little interference there with Josi, not allowing Holtby to play his position, but we will play on.
Patrick Kane made over to bring this one back in, laid one over for Landeskog that went wide. I think that was temporarily waived, like the offside was temporarily enforced. And I'm sure that the players are letting them know, but back ahead with this now comes Claude Giroux. He's got Aho. Giroux rang it off the post. There have been lots of posts today, but these guys can thread the needle pretty well. Here is Giroux, and then Aho, and a good save made by Rene. 4:50 to go. These guys can score pretty quickly, so let's see. Kane gives it over. It's returned by Rantanen to Kane. Looks toward Landeskog, gives to Rantanen. Drop back over to Kane. Kane with a shot, kicked back out again by Holtby, and started ahead alone by Aho. Aho in on a breakaway on Rene. He scores, and that makes it 7-3.
Well, Sebastian Aho of the Carolina Hurricanes is going to come in earlier in this game. His countryman Pecorine shut him down this time. He looks like he's going to go low, and he just elevates the puck up and over the catching glove. You see the glove dip down because he thinks it's going low. Great deception by Aho.
16 guys in these games today were point leaders on their teams, including Aho. As ahead is Cam Atkinson, and he scores! And it is now 8-3 in favor of the Metropolitan. 8 seconds later, another goal.
Well, right off the faceoff, Atkinson with 27 goals. Member of the Columbus Blue Jackets, and you can see why with that skill level, not an easy play to make, especially on your forehand. Beautiful goal.
Atkinson again, and that one is cut off and outletted ahead, and a 2-on-0. Wheeler nudges on. Mark Scheifele brings it in, and a stop made there by Holtby. Fed back across yet again, and Seth Jones is able to start back ahead. Tomorrow, Sunday, there are no games, but NHL action resumes on Monday. And right down through the first week of April, the line gets drawn. 16 qualify for the Stanley Cup playoffs, and 15 have their season over. Strong shot, and Rene made the stop and handed it off. Carried back ahead by Josi. And Josi crosses over but can't get the shot away, as Letang was nearby and so was Crosby defensively. And it is now Kane in the last 3:05. Kane dodges free, and a shot would not get through. The netminder is pulled. Rene is at the bench. Thank you, Eddie. And an extra man is out, as the Central has nothing to lose at this point but to try to get some going. Here is Crosby with the net yawning open. Across now for Barzal, and Barzal has scored twice today in this game, and now it is 9.
Nathan MacKinnon made that goalie pull. He was the one calling Pecorine off the ice. He's smiling on the bench now.
Oh.
I wonder what his head coach in Colorado, Jared Bednar, thinks of the captain standing behind the bench there. Little different shoes to stand in behind there. Not an easy job, that's for sure. Like the aggressiveness there of Nathan MacKinnon and Paul Maurice, the bench bosses for the Central team.
Ryan O'Reilly brings it on. Lennon Brennan, Yossi, tried to shove it by Holtby. Braden Holtby and Henrik Lundqvist have been impressive today, and Holtby just showed it again by diving out to cut that one off. And we have a halt to play as the referee lost sight of it, and so we're going to have a rare face-off in this game with 2:24 left to go.
You know, Doc and Eddie, I think the referee wanted to make sure that Braden Holtby was okay after that collision. Got a knee in the head. He seems to be fine.
Okay, good eye there, Pierre. Played on by Carlson, lobbed ahead now for the carry-on by Claude Giroux. Moving in with Aho. And gave it on to Carlson, and Carlson could not connect on that one, so it is carried back out again by Giroux and led back onto Aho, and then for Carlson. Trouble to take that one, but he was able eventually to get control and nudge it behind. And ahead now for Patrick Kane, moving up with Yossi. Kane with the shot and the save made by Holtby. And led back ahead, and Aho, and then Carlson. And fought off there by Rene. And then carried back up by Landeskog, and playing some catch with Rantanen, and he is able to score. So 9-4 with a minute and a half to go. You can see the magic these Colorado guys have, and of course in this game they just played catch. But scoring wizardry has been something that has been so dominant with them. 47% of Colorado's goals have been scored by either of those two or the guy who is coaching them from the bench today. Taken back out to center, Landeskog ahead, Rantanen moves in. Getting a piece of that was Holtby. And again, it's Wheeler. Score! Blake Wheeler.
Maybe you start with the goaltender out here with the faceoff at center ice. You're down by four. You only got a buck 10 left. Wheeler moves one way and shoots back the other way.
MacKinnon's pulling him now. He's waiting for him to come over.
He is.
Okay, won the draw.
Why not?
Yeah.
Go.
Here it comes.
Rene's at the hash marks. Now he charges to the bench. On comes Wheeler.
Somebody's got to go. Gonna give him a stick? What's he gonna do? You only got three guys out there.
Yeah, that's right. Heiskanen was straddling the boards as it shot in by Atkinson. Well, it helps to have the extra guy there. But at any rate, it is now 10-5.
I think they wanted to give Rene a player stick and maybe join the rush there or something.
I think one of the fours didn't want to get a minus. I'm not going out there.
And so Letang in these last 45 seconds. And Holtby just standing up there again, and the rebound went off of him, and O'Reilly turns, and the follow-up is yet again from Marzell. Well, Todd Reardon will be the victorious coach here, and Crosby again trying to fight his way through and score yet one more goal, cannot this time. So now it is Scheifele moving in alone on Holtby and sent it wide. And the Metropolitan will win this one. And divide the 1 million. And the final score in this game will be 10-5 Metropolitan over Central. At at the 64th NHL All-Star Game.
Smiles all around for the King, Henrik Lundqvist. While time was expiring, he was pumping his fist, high fives on the bench, and yeah, big smile.
Players gather around, not sure if there's going to be a handshake line. Sometimes this does happen, and yeah, sure enough, Patrick Kane and Sidney Crosby are the first to start it. And we will see plenty of smiles close up here as they go through. The rare time that they get to socialize and have a few laps when it's not the severest form of competition that goes every other night through four rounds and 8 weeks to win a Stanley Cup. Pierre McGuire with Sidney Crosby.
Thanks very much, Doc. How much fun did you have playing with Matt Barzal and Christopher Letang?
Yeah, it's fun, obviously. Play with Tanger for a long time, so be able to share this weekend with him is great. Barzal makes it pretty easy. I mean, he lugs the puck so well, he skates so well. Yeah, it was fun to be out there with him.
What have you learned about the game since you came in the league in 2005? Because clearly it's changed.
Yeah, it's just the speed. I think right through every team, you can see the speed every night. The league's so tight, you can see with the standings right now, but it's just so competitive.
Sidney, what does All-Star Weekend mean to you?
I think just celebrating the game. I mean, fans get to see the players up close, maybe in a different light too for the players, having a good time and not so much in the game mindset you typically see during the season. So I think everyone enjoys that aspect too.
Thanks a lot. We'll see you later on this week.
Sounds good. Thanks.
Doc.
It was at the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey, when at one of the practices, Don Maloney of the New York Rangers said that his philosophy for the game was going to be open it up, skate hard through center ice, and shoot for the car. Because that was the MVP prize. Well, by George, he won it. Well, we don't know who's going to wind up winning the car tonight, but you've been voting. And it is, in fact, Sidney Crosby of the Pittsburgh Penguins, who is the MVP of this game and receives an all-new 2019 Honda Passport Elite. Final score in this championship game, Metropolitan Division 10 and the Central Division 5. Thanks for watching the 2019 Honda NHL All-Star Game from San Jose. Pretty impressive afternoon and evening here in San Jose, where they have 300 days of sunshine, and today was one of those. And the greatest of stars did their best to put on a wonderful show. Coming up next, except on the West Coast, it's your local news. And later tonight, an all-new Saturday Night Live, host James McAvoy, musical guest Meek Mill. For our entire crew, Mike Emmerich saying so long from San Jose, California.